Explain, what is grime exactly?
Well, grime, the simplest way to put it, you know, for people who know nothing about grime, is it's almost like the UK's answer to hip-hop music in America. You know, grown out of East London, originally, inner city, council estates, kids kind of just reflecting their reality, their truth, influenced music, and that's how it all started.
Is taking the world by storm. Grime started in East London around 15 years ago and is now more popular than ever.
But the power is shifting to places like this and the talented young people who live in inner city Britain and are writing about their experience.
It took a couple years, but I met Dizzy.
Okay.
So Dizzy was at, I'd done music anyway, but Dizzy was, like the first person I met who made a type of music, and I was making a garage maybe, and when we come together, we form grime like that.
I created a musical landscape in the 70s and early 80s by giving New York or the Bronx, especially the Bronx, a musical foundation or a new start, because we were just coming off the 60s where the entire city was bankrupt. That environment kind of gave birth to hip hop. Hip hop is a culture based on four foundational elements: DJing, MCing or rap, graffiti, and breakdancing.
People use the terms interchangeably, rap with hip hop, whereas hip hop is the bigger culture. Rap is something you do. Hip hop is something you live.
Coming from the disco era, you know what I mean? We were inner city kids. We couldn't get into disco, so we had to recreate that disco. And that's what basically hip-hop started out as, like the bastard child of disco. I mean, it was our rebellion against that and our recreation of it at the same time.
Turntables became our instruments. Like, so a lot of people in the inner cities, they didn't have money for instruments. So you had to find those sounds somewhere. So you dug through your pop's Cradle Records and you're just listening for these different instruments and sounds. And then you pull from those different sounds and made a total new creation. People forget that the DJ is the backbone of hip hop. That's where it all started. DJ spinning that party. And then there was different parts of the record where you could talk over it and then the beat's still going, but you don't lose the attention of the record or the main part of the record. That evolved to MCs getting on the mic and just saying things to keep the party going, which evolved into actually rhyming and rapping, because these different MCs will have little sayings that they said. Kind of music or something like these black kids or Latin kids are doing in certain urban areas to an actual viable genre of music that reached middle America. I think institutions are trying to preserve hip hop. When you see places like art galleries, you see it in fashion, you see it in business. I think that's preserving hip hop, even when people don't realize that's actually preserving it. Created something from nothing. And hip hop was the first art form that spoke to me. People who looked like me, people I could look up to, the way they put these words together and tell these stories about places that look like where I live. And that's just like, what hip-hop is all about is just evolving and staying ahead of the curve and being something aspirational.
The similarities of the birth of hip-hop and grime are striking. It is no debate that hip-hop is the forefather and pioneer of the genre. What we will see are some parallels between their births and some reasons as to why this sound emerged. To begin with, both emerged from marginalized areas of some of the world's richest cities. Both emerged from areas ravaged by poverty and a lack of opportunity. And both were formed through creativity and innovation from creative minds. Contrast of the Upper East Side and the South Bronx in the 70s, London also had its disparity between rich and poor. One of the poorest areas in London was the East End, which also held communities of immigrants from across the world. There were struggles that were incomparable to other areas of London, which had higher levels of affluence. Like hip-hop, grime also took many influences from many cultures and combined to make its own sound. Growing up in one of these areas understandably created frustration and challenges. However, this will never hinder the power of creativity. In the late 90s, a genre of music known as UK garage had emerged and gained popularity amongst the mainstream. Whilst much of the popular UK garage sound fused soul and R&B with lighter and happier vocals,
take to be a garage MC, personality, originality, on a microphone it got to be, the capital U-N, the K-N-O, or get down, represents,
be sincere.
A darker garage sound was also appearing, which was more instrumental and less vocal.
Get M's all the time, when we go shopping by the latest design,
it's a boy, I'm in effect, directly from the L-O-S, E-tree, check it out, step it up, crew got,
oh no, that's the word, oh no, that's the word,
This would lead to an opportunity for MCs to lay down their own lyrics and begin to use this medium to express themselves and paint pictures of the world around them, and also to vent their anger and frustration with society. As with the Bronx, the sound that emanated from there was a canvas for rappers to paint the city in its truest form. As with grime, the sound is like the sound of the city. Producers created the atmosphere, feeling, and ambience. The MCs then filled it with stories, experience, and emotion to combine and create a world for others to see, feel, and hear. The UK in general has always been a pioneer of different sounds and genres, and this was no different in the 2000s with the improvements of home computers and also software that was more accessible. This led to an explosion of experimentation with lots of artists fusing together different sounds. With the help of pirate radio, which will always be one of the foundations of grime, DJs could play these darker sounds to MCs who would be able to flow over the beat. The creation of grime will forever be a grey area in the annals of history. Many artists and producers have claimed to be the forefather of grime, but it is still a debate that has never been settled. The first grime track is often debated. Some might argue it was Pay As You Go, some might argue it was So Solid Crew, or even producers like Pulse X or Johnny Cash. Some might even argue it was Wolverine's Adamantium Rage Boss 2 music, which came out on the SNES. But there's one artist who comes out every time in the argument of who was the first grime artist. There's always one artist that comes out on top when this conversation arises, and that is Wiley with his SD beat sound.
Yo, attack Creed, attack CKP right now, attack Kofi B.
Even in its earlier stages, grime hit the ground running as DJs were now playing a more instrumental sound for MCs. With the creation of Roll Deep Crew with Wiley and Dizzy, Nasty Crew, and also Rough Squad, these started a foundation for grime to build upon. More Fire Crew's Oi is released.
Who's that bully for me? The one around back, I just don't give it to me. Uh-oh, there's that bully for me. Uh-oh, there's that bully for me.
The BBC also launches BBC One Extra. This will be a staple for grime. It's noteworthy to mention the prominence of pirate radio and the importance it has not only for grime but other genres. Grime Rays had also become a part of the scene with notable mentions to Wiley's Eskimo Dance and Sidewinder.
Give it a damn, it's not a love thing, there's no ring in your hand. I've got time for you, but your man ain't show no time. Tell you ain't got time.
Channel U was undoubtedly the biggest and most successful platform before the rise of video sharing on the internet. This helped many artists present their music to a wider audience and gain recognition for their work. Dizzy Rascal released Boy in the Corner, which helped elevate grime into the mainstream. This also won him a Mercury Prize, and is still remembered as one of the best grime albums.
That's the kind of threat that you can't ignore. I'll put your thing down to the floor, but shut on till you said three max words. When it's the one for the verse.
Risky Rhodes also began documenting the grime scene. He also further released some of the most legendary DVDs.
Pow! Yeah, I'm lead for the beat. Pow! If you don't know about me, pow! Better ask someone quickly, cause pow! Yeah, I'm pow! You know?
This is also a massive year for releases in the scene, with albums such as Wiley's Treading on Thin Ice.
Yo, I can feel them getting closer to me. I heard they're searching for me high and low, they wanna know me now, okay. I can feel me getting closer to them. I've got that strap in the back of my mind and I'm prepared to take them down.
And Kano's Home Sweet Home.
Some manners don't like me, they try and badmind me when Kano comes to town. All I say is mine's right and they lose the limelight when Kano comes around.
Singles such as Wiley's What You Call It over his Igloo beat and Lethal B's Power bring more attention to the scene. Another important staple of grime is created by Jammer called Lord of the Mics. This also featured Wiley and Kano clashing. Lord of the Mics would give many artists a platform in the form of clashing. Practice Hours also begins filming the grime scene.
Best in the game, it was bait, we was gonna be here. Road Deems and they never up for awards all year. When you get here, haters wanna end your career. But we're live on stage, no fear when we're here. Back my team till the end is clear. I swear this will end in two.
The momentum of grime is becoming unstoppable, with now more and more artists joining the ranks. Roll Deep's In at the Deep End is released, as well as many singles and mixtapes by emergent MCs. Logan Sama's show on Kiss also begins, which will hold some of the most legendary after-hour sessions in grime history.
Men are walking a gang, men are walking a posse. Prison me call out the name of Selassie. Tell them why they feel cool, you're fussy.
So he ain't got no jack. If it ain't FT, then it is whack. Gala got a big butt, yeah, I did slap. Arch on my back, gave her the full pack.
Phone champion, no contest. A lot of man never thought I would ever get to say my piece. Can't believe the singles I released.
Come on, let me get them neck on the B.I.G. Just Cavani, B.N.G.
Do you get slapped up and slapped down? When you ask for the cycles, madhouse.
Can I play grand more or I'm in a job for the boy?
Logan Sama's show will also be a platform for artists to gain more widespread exposure.
Chow, you're established, but you can call me the flow father. I got the volcano flow, I flow lava. Heavyweight far from Marga, it's related to dynamite, but don't call it a collar.
Rolled up with the golf club, showed up, then you froze up like, oh fuck, hold up, I'm a gold nut, showing no love, donuts, get your phone sucked and your whole fucked.
Look how many men try it.
Don't violate me, fam, it won't work. Cock back the pump and see how it works.
Fine! Holy water flows like I swam from Jerusalem. The bishop had the juice for him, I came and diluted them. Mixed the recipe and broke bread like the Eucharist.
Weren't even on the music, Tim came out of jail and got influence. Got a little fame now, bear man, I say my name, huh, what a coincidence.
This year we'll see the grime scene having a permanent home on the internet after the creation of YouTube and Jamal Edwards starting his channel SBTV. This will lead to the now famous warm-up sessions and F64s and other freestyles, which gain many views on the platform. Online is where grime is staying strong. Websites such as Hood Tapes and Grime Forum are also gaining popularity online. And Jammer also brings a sequel to Lord of the Mites with a legendary clash between Skepta and Devilman.
Hold on, the man of inside the place, yeah? This is where it is happening, yeah?
Skepta, Devil Man.
Yeah, a big clash right about now.
See what I did to the other MCs on my diss track. How can I clash Devil Man?
The London Metropolitan Police's risk assessment form, known as Form 696, becomes a very controversial topic of discussion within the scene. It requests promoters and licenses of events to complete and submit. The form stipulation is that names, stage names, private addresses, and phone numbers of all promoters, DJs, and artists are listed. The form also asks for a description of the style of music to be performed and the target audience. The form also asks for details of ethnic groups likely to attend a performance. Grime's impact and legacy will forever leave a footprint in the culture of UK music. Grime began just as an idea from young creative minds which captured not only the country but spread around the world. It gave mostly young black men an opportunity to create a medium for others to understand their struggle and let them experience their world and their emotions. Just like the young people of the South Bronx who innovated and overcome their challenges, so did the young in London. There are many more stories and history to be told about this scene. This first part was a labor of love towards the grime scene. And to the producers, artists, DJs, and the people who helped drive the scene and gave me a soundtrack to my childhood, thank you. If you would like a part 2 to this series, please comment down below.